come before the Lord and play for Him on glad tambourines and let your trumpet sound. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let the song be sung from mountain side. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Sing it hallelujah.
A very good morning to you, my dear brothers and sisters. Welcome you all for this Holy Eucharist. Let us pray on this day for these intentions. Today is the seventh day of the soul of Joseph Fonseca, offered by Francis and Thelma Fonseca. Today is also a death anniversary of John Paul Chauhan, offered by Clancy, Vinita and family, for the soul of Bella Montero, offered by Luis and George Montero, and offered by Sabina Matthews. For the soul of Joseph and Bella Montero, offered by Cynthia Montero and family. For the soul of Martin D'Souza, offered by Rose D'Souza and family. For the soul of Sudgoda D'Souza, offered by Thomas D'Souza and family. Thanksgiving to Our Lady of Valenkani, offered by Cheryl D'Souza Futaro. For the soul of John Paul Chauhan, offered by Margaret Chauhan and family. For the good health of Mabel Kashmiro, offered by Mabel. Along with these intentions, my dear brothers and sisters, we pray for all those who are sick, all those who are suffering, and we pray for all your intentions. Remain in silence for a while in the presence of the Lord, admitting yourselves to the Lord and your intentions. We pray, invoking the Triune Spirit, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today in the gospel reading we hear Saint Peter acknowledging his own sinfulness and telling to Jesus, "Jesus, I am a sinful man, leave me." But Jesus does not leave him. Jesus invites him to be close to him, to be part of his mission, to be part of his family, and makes him the head of his family. My dear brothers and sisters, even when you and me are in sinfulness, when we acknowledge, Lord does not leave us or astray us, but he takes us into his company, into his family, and blesses us. This is what going to happen during this Mass to us. My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Let's now together confess our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. O God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep save what you have nurtured through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Make no mistake about it. If any of you thinks of himself as wise in the ordinary sense of the world, then he must learn to be a fool before he really can be wise. Why? Because the wisdom of this world is foolishness to God. As scriptures say, the Lord knows wise men's thoughts. He knows how useless they are. Or again, God is not convinced by the arguments of the wise. So there is nothing to boast about in anything human. Paul, Apollos, Cephas, the world, life and death, the present and the future are all your servants, but you belong to Christ. And Christ belongs to God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial psalm. Let your response be, the Lord, the Lord's is the earth and its fullness.
The Lord's is the earth and its fullness.
The Lord's is the earth and its fullness, the world and all its peoples. It is He who set it on the seas. On the waters he made it firm. Response,
the Lord's is the earth and its fullness.
Who shall climb the mountain of the Lord? Who shall stand in his holy place? The man with clean hands and pure heart, who desires are not worthless things. Response,
the Lord's is the earth and its fullness.
He shall receive blessings from the Lord and reward from the God who saves him. Such are the men who seek him, seek the face of the God of Jacob. Response,
the Lord's is the earth and its fullness.
Gospel acclamation, Alleluia, Alleluia. Through the good news, God called us to share the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus was standing one day by the lake of Gennesaret with a crowd pressing round him, listening to the word of God, when he caught the sight of two boats close to the bank. The fishermen had gone out of them and were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats, it was Simon's, and asked him to put out a little from the shore. Then he sat down, taught the crowds from the boat. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, put into deep water and pay out your nets for a catch. Master, Simon replied, we worked hard all night long and caught nothing, but if you say so, I will pay out the nets. And when they had done this, they netted such a huge number of fish that their nets began to tear. So they signaled to their companions in the other boat to come and help them. When these came, they filled the two boats to sinking point. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at the knees of Jesus, saying, "Leave me, Lord, I am a sinful man." For he and all his companions, completely overcome by the catch they had made. So also were James and John, sons of Zebedee, who were Simon's partners. But Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on, it is men who will catch." Then, bringing their boats back to land, they left everything and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, we speak about the faith of Peter. It is not that all of a sudden he grew as a wise man in faith. No. Gradually, at times, he said to Jesus, "Leave me, I am a sinful man," acknowledged himself, and in the future at his ministry, many times he realized he is unfit. He even denied Jesus. But knowing the character and the person of Peter, Jesus made him the head of the church. My dear brothers and sisters, the story goes this way. A child was thinking about his dad, that when he was very small, he thought his dad was everything. He knows everything. He is a great wise man. But as a child grew up, he thought his dad knows nothing, because child began to learn more and more. And later stage, when child grew up, he understood that what the child learned was only knowledge, but what dad has taught him at early age of the child was the wisdom. The child, as he grew up, he has realized his dad was again a perfect and wise man. My dear brothers and sisters, in the same way, the Simon Peter at the beginning, he acknowledged his sinfulness, he grew, and he grew unto deep faith. It is the story of yours and mine. We begin our lives with a little faith, and we journey with God, and we deepen ourselves in faith. My dear brothers and sisters, when can we deepen our faith? As Simon Peter kept a boat available to Jesus, we need to keep our lives available to Jesus, where Jesus can come and preach for us from the boat of our lives. Let's continue to pray that we may be inspired through the teachings of Jesus and grow in faith as Saint Peter grew up. Offertory. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we offer you this bread, the fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we offer you this wine, the fruit of the earth, work of your hands. It will become for us the spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
Let us pray. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and every way to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, and without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Godfrey and Stania bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We remember all the souls for whom we pray. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all gathered here, O Lord. Give us your grace that we may grow in faith like Simon Peter, and always embrace you, O Lord, to lead the church and the work that is entrusted to us. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, and with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, a God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now pray to our Heavenly Father.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all, always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace
be with you all.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
May the receiving of your body and blood, Lord Jesus Christ, not bring me to judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy, be for me a protection and a healing remedy.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from heavenly table, we beseech you, O Lord, that being the food of charity, it may conform in our hearts, stir us to serve you in our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go and proclaim Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Have a beautiful day, my dear brothers and sisters. God bless you all.
Into the street. of his spirit.